Kojima.
One of the things that you've told me is Super Potato, which is very stirring, store in Tokyo, it's an old school game. And he picked up the Mario cartridge, the original Mario, and he said, without this game, I wouldn't be doing this.
Yes, Mario! Run and jump.
So when you saw that, what made you think I can be cinematic with this?
He's sure.
So back then, Morden, images, but you were just trying to see what you could represent in terms of drama, in terms of story, whether it be full text, it was something completely different from movies, which was a challenge. How to make something similar, stories and stuff, using methods so different from those that were available.
それだけで、マリオはものすごい冒険をプレイヤーと共にしてくれるんですよね。で、そこに感銘を受けて、当時は、カメラワークもできませんでしたけども、いつからそうなるっていうのを、未来が分かってましたんで、それで、ゲーム業界に飛び込んだんですけども、こんなに早く、映画に追いつけるというか、映画のような画面が作れる、音響が使えるっていう風になるとは、当時は思いませんでした。
All you had available for the player was having the D-pad and the A button and the B button, and that was it. And only using that, the player was led to so impressive adventures. Mario went through so many adventures. So I can play with a camera, but I knew that one day I'd be able to always move naked into games. I could see that future coming. The one thing I didn't imagine was that that they would come so fast. So I knew that eventually those methods available would be available as well.
で、30数年前にマリオに出会って、そこでゲームに出会って、ゲームの可能性に出会って、今の僕があります。
So, very some years ago, I had my first encounter with Mario, and I hope that's what led to who I am today.
Yo, this guy's a good translator, man.
ゲームっていうのはマリオと一緒で、普通の人よりも速く走って高く飛んで、空を飛んだりする、すごく自分ができないことをゲームというバーチャルなところで超能力を発揮する、それを、カタルシスにするゲームが多いんですけども、デスストランディングはその真逆を言ってます。
So yesterday also I showed a trailer for Death Stranding. I cannot go into too much detail about that. Mario is at the basis of games. Is there, the basis for so many games where Mario tries to go faster than faster, jump higher, and some games that you can fly, do whatever you want, have these unusual abilities that exploiting those abilities give a catharsis to the player. Now, in Death Stranding, I'm trying to go for the opposite of this.
Ooh, it's going for the opposite where it's just like hard to move, really difficult to navigate the world.
So that's nothing. Norman get tripped into stones, he's also be careful with his balance and water, can be taken away by a river, and all these elements are there because of Mario.
I just like to think about
cool.
Mm-hmm,
so I feel.
In a medium that didn't exist for
ければいけないのかっていう全く説明がなくて。
So back in MSX, for example, you had an enemy, you had to defeat the enemy. There was no way, that was the only thing, that was the role. You were never given a reason why you have to defeat that enemy.
で、まあそこに僕は疑問があって、でそこを説明したゲームを作りたいっていうことなんですけども、つまりそれはゲームでドラマがなかったんですよ。キャラクターの意思とか動機とか背景、モチベーションが描かれてなかったので、それを描こうとしました。
So I, and I have questions about that. I wanted to make a game that explained that, which in other words, games that never, the games didn't have drama back then, and I wanted to have this dramatic elements, a build to the character, a motivation, a reason why the character is doing something.
とはいえ、当時のキャラクターは、顔もなくて、まあドットなんですけど、顔もなくて表情もなくて、言葉も持たない、そういう、ハードだったので、それが今や、喋って表情も動きもその年齢も説明しなくていいんですね。ビジュアルで何歳ぐらいの人で性別も分かって、大体どういう人種の人かも分かる、服装とか、持ってる時計とかイヤリングとか装備品でその人の背景が分かる、そのぐらいのディテールが描けるようになったって、当初やりたかったことが今ようやくできるようになってきたという感じです。ゲームをやっててよかったな、途中でやめずにやっててよかったなと思います。
So back then, characters have a face and expression. I mean, they were dot, they were dot art, so they didn't have words. That was the hard one back then. Nowadays, though, the characters talk, they have their facial expression, they have their own unique movements, you know, you can convey all these things just visually without any need to explain this. What range they are, the clothes, what kind of accessories they wear, the equipment, all these details. Finally, then you can convey them in the games. And, you know, looking back at that makes me feel really happy that I didn't leave the gaming industry before. What just happened to me?
I want to talk about the sort of hidden and invisible, in my assessment, Olympic-sized backflips that you do for your cinematics. And specifically, all of you should go back and watch not the most recent Death Stranding trailer, but the last one. Or you should go and look at a lot of the cutscenes in Phantom Pain. Because he's going from a world of very traditionally cinematic cut, angle, new angle, cut, to these very long, unbroken frames. And normally in cinema you see a virtual camera, and it reeks of being computer-generated, because it's doing these long, sweeping moves with the wearable. Zoom across the landscape in 3 seconds. It feels naturally CG. But you started doing something where you started taking that virtual camera and making it feel handled. And so you do these very long, unbroken takes, and they're incredibly long, but they feel fluid, and they feel authentic, and they feel natural. I think you were one of the first people doing that, and now you see things like God of War as one continuous unbroken take of route. You guys should go and watch those cutscenes. I want to talk about that process. How did that come to you? How do you block a scene in the midst of that technique? To me, it's sort of a groundbreaking thing that hasn't even been done properly in film. It's a very new thing. So I just want to talk about where that came from.
そもそも、ゲームって一つのカメラなんですね。プレイヤーが操作しているカメラでずっと進んでいきます。
So first off, games is like one they rely on one camera, the one camera that is following the player.
3D になってから。3D になる前は2次元なんでカメラじゃないです。フレームしかないです。
First,
紙芝居です。
All that started in 3D, but back then it was only 2D. It was just, you know, there was no camera. But this was the camera from the 3D.
で、プレイヤーのカメラが一つでずーっと、まあ、プレイヤーの視点のゲームがありますけど、で、カットシーンになると全然違うカメラになるっていうのが、まあ、昔のゲームです。これは仕方がないので、そこ CG ムービーとかにして、あるいはアニメーションのカットシーンとかありますけど、そこでいきなり違うカメラに変わります。
So, the camera, now, when we go to 3D era, the camera on following the player, although there are some things for the cameras from the player's perspective. However, you're playing, and then you come to the cutscene, then the camera has to change. This is inevitable because of technology, because back then there was pre-rendered movies or animations, and it just took you out of there as a kind of change.
これ皆さんちょっと誤解されてるんですけど、普通ゲームシーンとカットシーンって同じところで作ってません。ほぼ、ほとんどそうですね。カットシーンは映画会社とか別のところに作ってもらってます。演出をしているのは別の人です。
Now, one thing that most people don't get right is that in most games, game scenes and cutscenes are made separately, are made in different places. For the most part, cutscenes are there by someone else, by a filmmaking
company.
And I disagree with this method. I think that whether it's a main camera or a top camera, the same person that is directing should be directing this.
で、本当の理想形は、プレイヤーのカメラは一つなので、まあ、動かせなくて、ズームしたり、このままズームにカットシーンもつながって、カットシーンはプレイヤー操作できないんですけども、同じようにワンカメラで情報を追っていく。で、またゲームにそのままのカメラでずっと入っていって、まあ、一つのカメラでオープニングからエンディングまでを捉えたものっていうのが、ゲームとしてはすごく理想的だと思います。で、それを、まあ、数年前からやってるだけです。
Now, the deal is that there's always only one camera for the player constantly, the player controlling the character and then going into the cutscene, losing control of the player of the character, but still smoothly going from cutscene to in-game and vice versa, and one camera going back into the game with the same camera. So ideally, you have one of these one camera from the opening of the game to the ending of the game. Well, I've been trying to do this in this game. Well, in
the game, Hitchcock's Rogue or Tomorrow World or Sevier or Tomorrow.
And in the film industry, you know, that Hitchcock, people that have been trying to do the same thing with Hitchcock and Rogue or Alfonso Cuarón that have been trying to do this. There are people that have. So I think, well, this is, in a way, this is another methodology to
And
I'm pretty sure you're familiar with this, but doing actually trying to do this is extremely
difficult.
And this is, you know, even if you have the block beforehand and you have
キャラクターを配置と、ここでこの情報を出していく、このカメラでこれを見せて、ピン送りでっていうのは、そのすごく計算して作らないといけないんで、非常に緻密にしないといけません。アクションシーンとかはワンショットで撮るようなものですよね。
It's like trying to take an action scene all day in one cut altogether.
で、大体、まあ、冗談って言いますけど、この人形さんとか、マップで、位置決めて、カットからそう撮るっていうのをまずやります。
So, well, you, Jordan, you're familiar with this, but you first start with doing the dolls and putting it in a map and defining the positions for which everything will be.
で、それでまず固め、今度自分たちでやります。スタッフを集めて、あなたこの役、私はこの役でカメラ回して動きの確認です。
And now, once you have this layout with the tools, then you start doing it yourself. In our case, we get staff members, and alright, we will play this character, or this will be over here, and we try to shoot them with the camera ourselves.
で、今度はプリビズで CG にそれを置いて、動きも全部シミュレーションして、今度背景に何が必要か、どの距離に必要かも全部。
And once that is done, then we try to do a previous visualization in the computer graphics, putting that in the computer, starting to calculate, right, we need this in the background, we need this element, here we need to add this or that, or something like this.
で、それをもとにセットを組んで、パフォーマンスキャプチャーで動いてもらって、今度は俳優さんによってその A から B に行くスピードが変わったりするので、人の動きって全部違うので、そこで微調整をして、 さらにそこでアイデアを付け加えて、ロープカットを作ってます。
So, and using that, then you will set, you're doing the performance capture, you have the actors, and depending on the actors, these are different speeds, not what you calculated, because each person moves at a different speed, so you adjust based on that, and then with the, once I, all that is done, that's way, that the way you get it, getting this one thing on one cut.
まあ、そういうやり方なので、チャンピオンがターミネーター2で4号のシーンでやったと同じように模型をさっき作ってカメラを決めてしまうとこっち側は作らなくていいので、カメラの動きと俳優の動きとセットの、レイアウトが決まると映らないところはあのカットシーンに関してはディテールは必要ないのでそこはすごく効率がいいです。
And well, the, in this regard, the methods that James Cameron uses, you know, having a maquette of everything, having the camera, the set, the layout, that allows you to have a lot of detail beforehand, and that makes the process a lot more effective.
I really can't express how difficult what he's talking about is. It essentially is a ballet. Like, in a normal scene, you can cut away to what you want. You can be on this person, and you can cut to a reverse, you can introduce something. The way that his cuts have been working lately, it goes from the in-game gameplay, it latches onto the character, develops around, finds someone new, travels a distance, finds something else, comes back, and all in one continuous, unbroken thing, which becomes this incredibly complicated thing. Blockhead is difficult to begin with. What he's talking about is even more difficult. And to me, it's so fascinating looking at the evolution of how you made people feel something cinematic with the original Metal Gear. Snatcher and Lee's thoughts created a much more filled and full world cinematically. And then you go into like proper sort of traditional Hollywood cinema in the original Metal Gear. And now the most cinematic version of that is actually these unbroken shots that sort of use the gameplay and the game. It really is masterful. But specifically, when you're moving that camera, like you told me, I brought up the Gecko scene in Metal Gear 4 with Raiden, which is a masterful, it's an incredible action sequence that goes toe-to-toe with any contemporary action scene in existence. You told me you were taking dozens, and you were moving them over. Block out that whole thing. Normally that would go to a second unit director, that would go to another team. I'm proud of the fact that my action is something that I'm super hands-on with. Talk to me about taking those dolls and choreographing that whole scene battle.
そうです、特にダイレンとゲットが戦うところはもう人間ではできないので人形でファンファの人と何度も打ち合わせしてここでこうしたくぐってこうしてあしてっていうのが何度もありました。
Yeah, especially that scene, that battle scene of the Gekos and Raiden, their movements impossible to achieve for people, so we were doing endless with the dolls, talking to people, alright, this goes there andWe're gonna try to do this.
ワンショットで撮るとですね、いいんですけど、スピード感がなくなったりするんです。そこが非常に難しいところで。
I like to do things in one shot, but unfortunately, one feel the downside of doing this is that feeling the speed gets lost.
そこからそこまでずっとこうカメラ寄って、撮り入れ寄ってきたって持たないんです。その間に情報が流れないんです。
If you go from here to there and you're just bowling it that way, you know, it's not interesting.
そこは頭を打つかないときだ。その観客の顔を一度映して、天井を映すとか、あるいはブレードランナーでリオリー・スコットがやったり、レイチェルが出てくるところは途中でライトで影にして一回連絡してパッと出すとか、そこは非常にこう頭を使うところですけど、ここが非常に面白いと思います。
That's where you really have to use your brain.I don't know, panning at the audience in between or showing something interesting. That's something that Ridley Scott, for example, did masterfully in Rachel, and that's where she's getting close and the lights go off and then she's closer. You know, you get this kind of idea.
Alright. I'll see you guys in the next one.